everyone. I am very happy to meet you once again through our SAR Learning Center YouTube channel. In this video, I am going to explain how to generate a prime number. What is our objective? Generate a prime number less than the given data. Okay, what is the condition of the prime number? A number is prime if it is divisible only by one and the same number. Okay, and it should not divisible by any other number. Okay, this is the condition of the prime number. Once again, I repeat, a number is prime if it is divisible only by one and the same number. For example, okay, if you are taking the 5, the 5 is the prime number or not? The 5 is divisible by 1 and is also divisible by 5 only, not for the less than the number. Okay, that's why the 5 is a prime number. Okay, now my question is, how we are going to verify the number is prime or not? We can divide the number by all the possible integers less than the given number and verify the remainder. What is the remainder? If the remainder is 0 in any of the division, the number is not a prime number. For example, okay, number 8. Number 8 is divisible by 4. If you are going to divide by the 4, the remainder is 0. That's why the 8 is not a prime number. Okay, in the same case, 7. 7 is not divisible by 4, not divisible by 3, is not divisible by 6, not divisible by 2. Because of, if you are divide by 2 or divide by 3 or divide by 4 or divide by 6, the remainder is not a 0. Okay, that case, the 7 is the prime number. If the remainder is non-zero in all the division, then we can say the number is a prime. I want to explain with example. Okay, the first example, number 1. It is always prime number. Next number is 2. Okay, the 2 is only divisible by 1 and 2 only. Okay, that's why this is a prime number. Next number is 3. 3 divided by 2. Okay, 3 is divided by 3 is 1. And 3 is divided by 1 is a 3. The remainder is 0. By our condition is, a prime is a divisible only by 1 and the same number. Here we are going to check number 2. The remainder is non-zero. That's why the 3 is a prime number. Clear. Next 4. 4 is divisible by 4 and 1 as well as the 2. 4 divided by 2, the remainder is 0. That's why this is not a prime number. Next 5. Okay, 5 is divisible by 5 and also 5 divided by 1. Okay, it is a condition. Next case, we are going to check with 4. Okay, 5 divided by 4, remainder is 1. Okay, then 5 divided by 3, the remainder is 2. And 5 divided by 2, the remainder is prime number. Next 6. Okay, 6 divided by 5, remainder is 1. 6 divided by 4, remainder is 2. 6 divided by 3, okay, the remainder is 0. In this case, okay, it is a prime or not? This is not a prime number. This is not a prime number. Why? This prime number means the number is divisible only by 1, okay, only by 1 or the same number. Here the 6 is divisible by 3. That's why this is not a prime. Okay, clear. Next 7. Okay, 7. Okay, 7 divided by 6, the remainder is 1. And 7 divided by 5, that remainder is 2. And 7 divided by 4, the remainder is 3. 7 divided by 3, the remainder is 4. And 7 divided, the remainder is 1. 7 divided by 2, the remainder is 1. And okay, that's why this is a prime number, because of this is a prime number. Okay, next case, number 8. Okay, the 8 is divided by the 2 also, and the remainder is 0. And 8 is divided by the 4, this is 0. That's why this is not a prime. This is not a prime, because of 8 is divisible by 2 as well as the 8 is divisible by 4. This is okay, that's why this is not a prime number. Next 9. The 9 is a prime or not? I am say it is a not a prime number. Okay, because 9 is divisible by 3. Remainder is 0. That's why this is not a prime number. Okay, next, 10 is divisible by 2 and it is divisible by 5. In all cases, the remainder is 0. That's why this is not a prime. Next number is 11. Okay, 11 is not divisible by any other number. It's only divisible by 1 and is only divisible by 11 only. That's why this is a prime number. Like that, we are going to generate a prime number. Now, I am going to write an assembly language program to generate a prime numbers less than the given data. Okay, how we are going to generate a prime numbers? By using the 8086 microprocessor. This is our program to generate a prime numbers. What is the first step? Here we are going to set the SI register as a pointer for the end data. Okay, for example, we are going to generate a prime number up to the 17. Okay, this is the end data. Okay, like that, we are going to put your data in the particular memory location. That's why move SI comma 1100H. The 1100H is mentioned the memory address. This is the pointer address. This pointer address to load the our end data. Okay, what is the next step? This end data is moved into the DEL. Okay, DEL is a general purpose register. This SI register is containing the, that is a memory address as a pointer address. This pointer address memory location containing the end data. This end data is moved into the DEL memory location. What is the next step? Move DI comma 1200H. This point sees DI as a pointer for storing the prime numbers. Okay, the first prime number, it can be stored in this 1200H. The second prime number to be stored in 1201H. Next prime number is stored in 1202H memory location. Like that, okay, this DI memory location, DI register value can be incremented step by step. What is the next step? Next step is move BL comma 01H. What is the meaning? Initialize the number to be checked as a 1. Okay, the first number is 1. Okay, then the DL register is containing the value of 01. This is the first prime number. The first prime number can be moved into the particular memory location. This memory location address, that pointer is available in the DI. This address is available in this DI register. Okay, now the BL value is moved into the 1200H memory location. The BL register contains the value of 01. This is the first prime number. Next, we are going to increment of the DI. Why we are going to increment of the DI? The second prime number can be stored in this next memory location. Next, increment of the BL. Now the BL value becomes 02. Okay, next line, move CL comma 02H. Okay, set the initial divisor as 02. In all cases, the initial divisor as 02. Okay, then compare BL comma CL. What is the value of BL? 2. What is the value of CL? 2. Now we are going to compare these two values. If the two values are equal, we can store the data in the particular memory location. Okay, the BL register's value can be stored in this particular memory location. That is a prime number. It is not equal. What is going to happen? In this case, we are going to check and verify this number is prime or not. Move AH comma 00H. Next, the BL register's value is moved into the AL. Next, the CL divide CL. DIV means we are going to divide the CL. The CL register value is 02. It is an initial divisor. Clear? The initial divisor is 02. Okay. Next, compare AH. Okay. If the division operation, the remainder can be stored in AH register. This AH register's value can be compared with the 00H because of remainder is 0 or not. If the remainder is 0, what is going to happen? Okay, come to this line. If remainder is 0, we are going to check increment of the BL. Increment of the BL. Because of the number is divisible by 2. Okay. For example, number 4. It can be divisible by 4. Okay. That is not a prime number. Okay. That's why we are going to get the another prime number. That's why we are going to get the another number. That's why we are increment of the BL. Okay, 4 to 5. Okay, increment of the BL. Now the value becomes 5. Okay, compare BL, DL. The DL value becomes is the end data. If the end data is reached, okay, what is going to happen? The program is halted. It is not reached. If the number is checked, it's not equal. What is going to happen? Again, the steps can be again, this step can be repeated. Again, move 0 to, okay, initial divisor because of next data can be loaded. What is the next data? The 5. Okay, the 5 is available in BL register. Now we are going to compare with this CL. Okay, now compare with this CL. So is it equal or not? It is not equal. Okay, then what is going to happen? If equal, we're going to store the data. Okay, it is not equal. What is going to happen? We are going to check. Okay, we are going to clear the AH register as a 00H because we are going to store the remainder in AH register. Then move BL data into the AL and is divisible by CL. Okay, clear? CL. CL value is 02. Okay, the BL value becomes 05. Now the remainder is 1. Okay, clear? Now we are going to check AH 00H. Here the remainder is not 0. That's why we are going to increment of the CL. The increment of the CL means the value becomes 03. Again, we are going to repeat this process. Comparison of the BL and CL. BL value becomes 5 and CL value becomes 3. Okay, it is not equal. Again, this step can be repeated whether the remainder is 0 or not. Once the step can be completed, if the remainder is not equal to 0, the number is a prime number. That's why move BL, DI. This step can be completed. Okay, this is the increment divisor is jump into here. Once the step can be repeated again and again, it is not equal. Okay, not equal to 0. The data can be stored in DI memory location. Once again, we are going to increment of the DI. Again, we are going to get the another number. Like that, we are going to generate a prime numbers. This is the summary of this program. First, what is the first step? Move SI, 1100H. It is a pointer of the end data. Next, the end data is moved into the DL. Next, move DI, 1200H. This is the pointer for the storing the prime numbers. So now move BL, 01. It is a initialize the prime number to be checked as a 01. It is the first prime number. That's why this prime number is moved into the, okay, storing the data into the particular memory location. Next, increment of the DI. We are going to move into the 1201 memory location. Increment of the BL, that value becomes 02. Okay, now we are going to set the CL value becomes 02 because of the first initial divisor as a 02. Now we are going to compare with BL and ZL. If both values are equal, the number is a prime number. That's why the value can be stored in this BL value can be stored in this DI. Again, we are going to increment of the DI. Again, we are going to increment of the BL. Okay, if you compare BL as a DL, why we are going to compare BL as DL? If both values are equal, the program is halted. Is not equal, again we are going to set the CL as a 02. Again, we are going to compare with BL, ZL. If you are equal, is a prime number. If it's not equal, go to the next step, move AH, 00H. Okay, next, move AL, BL. That is the number can be loaded into this AL. Okay, we are going to divide by the CL. Okay, the CL value becomes 02 initially. Okay, after that, the CL value becomes incremented step by step. Check whether the divisor, okay, check the remainder is 0 or not. Okay, if the remainder is 0 of the in between any number, this is not a prime number. Okay, clear? If it is not equal to 0, if the remainder is not equal to 0, okay, the number is prime number. In this case, the data can be stored in this particular memory location. Okay, clear? Now I am going to execute this program by using this emulator. Okay, that is a no error. Okay, initially I am going to show the memory. This is the memory. In this memory address is 1100. Okay, this is the set the end data. The end data in this example I am going to take 0C. Okay, 0C. That is a number 12. Okay, A for 10, B for 11, and C for 12. Okay, next, which one is our storing our data? 1200 memory location. Okay, now I am going to execute this program step by step. What is the first step? Okay, SI value become 1100. Okay, this SI value memory location contain the value of 0C. That value is moving to the DX memory location. Okay, that means the DL memory location. Next, okay, DI memory location's value becomes, the DI register's value become 1200. Next, the BL register's value becomes 01. Okay, now the BL register as the first prime number, that value is moved into the DI. Look at here, this is the 00. Now, the execution of this program, this value becomes 01. Next, we are going to increment of the DI and increment of the BL. Now, the BL register's value becomes 02. Okay, now, 02, that is a divisor, initial divisor is moved into the CL register. Okay, CL register. Next, we are going to compare these two number. Okay. If comparison operation we are going to perform, okay, look at, okay, where is a flag? Okay, this is a flag. Now we are going to compare BL, ZL. Okay, what is going to happen? In this comparison, both values are equal. Okay, both values are equal. That is why the zero flag value becomes one. Okay, that's why this is a prime number. That value can be moved into the particular memory location. There is a prime number. Okay, that's why this is a prime number. The 02 value becomes prime number. Why? It's only divisible by 1 and 2. Okay, that's why this is a prime number is moved into the particular memory location. The memory location address is 1201. Look at here, the DI value becomes 1201. Look at here, 1201 value becomes 00. If you are executing this line, okay, that value updated here, 02. Next, we are going to increment of the DI. DI value become 1202. It can be stored in this prime number. Okay, increment of the BL. Okay, the BL value becomes 03. Next, compare BL, DL. Why we are going to compare this BL, DL? We are going to find this is the end data or not. Okay, if you are end data, the program is halted. This is not end data, is go again. We are going to check the number. Okay, divisible by 02. Compare here, both numbers are not equal. That's why we are going to move into this line, move AH, 00H. Okay, AH value can be store the remainder. Okay, next, this BL value. Okay, BL value is moved into the AL because of we are going to divide by using this 02 value. Okay, AL value becomes 03. Okay, CL value becomes 02. Now we are going to divide the CL value. The remainder can be stored in this AH. Now we are going to check AH value becomes 0 or not. Okay, if the value becomes 0, okay, it is not a prime number. Okay, clear? It is not equal to 0, that's why, okay, what is going to happen? Okay, increment of the CL value becomes 03 and ZL value becomes 03. Again, repeat operation, CL value become 3 and BL value become 3. Now both values are equal. If the both values are equal, this is the prime number. This number can be loaded in this particular memory location 03. Like that, we are going to generate the prime number by using this program. Okay, our end data is 12. Okay, the first prime number is 1. The next prime number 2, 3, 5, 7. What is the next prime number? Okay, it take more time because of we are going, this is 11, B is 11. We are going to check the remaining smaller value. Okay, divisible by the remaining smaller value. That's why it takes more time. Okay, the value becomes 0B as a prime number. Okay, 0B means it's 11. In the decimal number is 11. Okay, in a hexadecimal number is 0B. Okay, these are the prime numbers in between the 1 to 12. 1, 2, 3, 5, 7 and B. Okay, clear? This is the concept of generation of the prime number. Okay? Thank you.